गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, सम ऑफ यू आस्क मी लास्ट टाइम दैट हाउ टू रिमूव दोज ट्विग्स और द ब्रांचेस कमिंग नियर टू द बॉडी ऑफ द बर्ड और बॉडी ऑफ द एनी सब्जेक्ट इन योर फ्रेम. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू टू टू टिप्स. वन इज समबडी हैड आस्क मी हाउ टू ऐड द सिग्नेचर ऑन द इमेज. सो आई विल शो यू दैट सिग्नेचर ऑल्सो एंड आई विल ऑल्सो शो यू हाउ टू रिमूव दोज ट्विग्स बाय सिंपल ट्रिक्स. We have two, three methods, but today I will show you two simple tricks by using a healing brush and by using the stamp tool. So let's start the have a look at the healing brush first. You have to select the healing brush, then select the size so you can enlarge the size as you wish. It should be little bit bigger enough than the those leaves or the twigs you have. Sometimes it may not go into first stroke, so you apply it for 2-3 times and it will go. Whenever you are going near to the body of the subject, you should be little careful while applying the healing brush. But most of the time it will do the good job because the AI built in the Photoshop is very good. So whenever we are playing near the body of the bird, we can use the stamp tool. You can select the stamp tool from the left side panel, then select the color nearby the body and apply it. So it will go. Now, while touching the body of the bird, we will enlarge it and again use the stamp tool and take the small size brush and select the color and remove. Now we will again go back to the healing brush, bring the healing brush here, select the right size of the brush and apply it. So you can see that it has removed very nicely. Now we can use the healing brush. Now we will use stamp tool to correct a few things from here. So select some size and apply it here. So if you see it now, while as a purpose of demonstration I have done little fast, but still you can do that. You will not even find now that trace of any twig or any branch near the bird's body or any subject body. Now what happens here is that we have this area where we use the healing brush, there are some marks over here. So what we will do is we will use the brush and you can select the flow size as between 5 to 8 so that it applies the color very smoothly. So let's go to the bottom here and you can see the color palette will pop up. Now select the color here, whichever you want. And start applying it over here. So you will find that if the brush size is increased, it will be a little more smooth. So you can apply it and those marks will go away. Similarly, we have done some work in the green patch, so we will select the green color here and apply here also. We should be little careful while going near the body of the bird and select the small size brushes and apply it so that it becomes very smooth. So select double click on the color palette, come to here because it will give you picker, then that picker can select the right color, okay it and apply it. So this is where you can now remove those twigs very effectively. So this was the first liquid which I have shown you. Now I'm going to show you how to add your signature. So I'm opening my signature which is in PNG format. So you can see the signature over here which is a transparent. You can see my name in black. The rest is transparent. This is a PNG format signature created with the help of Photo Logo. So now what I have to do is Control A control C so that I have selected the signature, copied the signature. For Mac users, it's a command A, command C. Then go back to the image first, what we saw, we show here. And I have already put the original signature via which I will remove it right now for your convenience. So I'm just deleting it with the help of Content Aware tool. Deselect. Now I will paste the signature by Control V, or for Mac users, Command V. Then just say Control T or Command T, your signature will get selected. Move this signature to the corner wherever you want, and then resize it. So I'm clicking on the width, and you can see the change symbol, so it reduces in appropriate size in all corners. So you can see that I am making a smaller signature, which I keep on the always on the top right. I am not really worried if somebody copies my photograph or remove the signature and use my photograph. I am not worried on that count. But I always keep my signature on the top right. Some people would love to keep it on the branch or the body of the bird or the body of the subject so that it cannot be stolen or it cannot be reused by somebody else. But I am not worried on that count, so I put my signature. So here were there two tips today for you. One is how to remove the branches and how to add the signature. So thank you friends for watching. Next time I will get you one more tip. Thank you very much.